Welcome to Sedona, Arizona, and I'm going to talk about deserts and dry climates. This is June, and let me tell you some characteristics about a desert climate. So I want to talk about the BW versus the BS. The BW is the true desert. Typically gets, you know, 15 inches of rain or less. We're not really going to talk about that, the absolute amount of rainfall, but we're going to talk about evapotranspiration here in just a second. This is a hostile climate in the BWs. It's very hot here. It's 109 here in June. And so plants and animals have to adapt, like that rabbit has to have thin ears and big tall ears to cool itself, and plants like this cactus below me here have to have spikes to keep the animals from eating them and have to be very water efficient. Okay, so here we are looking at some sagebrush here near the Sedona Airport here, high in this plateau. So we are pretty high, and we're really on the edge of between the BW and the BS. The BS is a steppe, by the way, versus the true desert. And so we do have some sagebrush here. We have some junipers here. So it's clear that we're on the edge of those two types of deserts. Typically, you get about 10 to 25 inches of rain in the steppe. In the dry climates here. A few other things about it is grasslands, grazers. We've seen some antelope around here. Of course, deer, any kind of animal that can eat grass. I saw a really cool hawk earlier with a mouse in its mouth. So it's kind of a neat spot here, a lot of beautiful scenery. Okay, so we do have hot and cold deserts. You know, the Saharan is a hot desert. This is more of a cold desert. And when we do get rain in these types of deserts here, in this case here, the cold desert, it can really dump. Coming in July here in Sedona is the monsoon season, and it will just dump in the afternoon. You can see some clouds brewing right now. I'm told by July, you know, they get some real downpours, and that can cause some flash floods if you're in these little narrow canyons. There's a lot of canyons. We're not far from the Grand Canyon, in fact. So let's wrap this up in Sedona. This is just an amazing sunset going on behind me. That's what Sedona is famous for. So there are three things that cause a desert. The first one, and the primary reason, is that at 30 degrees in latitude, whether you're north or south, the air tends to subside. So it rises at the intertropical convergence zone, you know, often at the equator around the equinox, and then it comes back down or subsides at the subtropical highs. That's where we are. So that's sinking, subsiding air. That's number one. Number two, you could be on the backside of a mountain, like the Sierra Nevadas. It's very dry in Reno, Nevada, and you know, anywhere along the backside of the Sierra Nevadas. And then three is like in Baja California, you've got these cold ocean currents, and that adds to the aridity as well. The cold ocean air dries out. The cold water dries out the air and then creates a true desert. You see that in Baja. So let's just say goodbye to Sedona together here. I'm leaving tomorrow.